Are you struggling to focus on your work? Do you feel you have a lot of distractions and unable to concentrate on important things of your life? Then this is the right video. I have been doing a 5-day online journey called Super Productive Bootcamp. In that bootcamp, I'm asking my students about what is that main problem that is stopping them to become very productive. You know, 90% of the problem is focus. Focus. I repeat that, it's focus. If you're really struggling to focus on your work and you feel you cannot concentrate on important things of your life, then this is the exact video you should watch now. If you're really excited to know more, just watch the video till the end. In this video, I'm going to show you a 6-step framework to improve, to boost your focus in a more ambitious way in just 6 steps. Excited? Type excited in the comment box. Just forget about my background, because we are changing a new house where the background is not yet set up there clearly, but still I decided to do the video. Still I decided to serve you and make you more productive. And in this video I'm going to clearly show you how you can improve, your focus to next level, right? Let us jump into the mind map where I'm going to show you the exact step-by-step process. Not only that, if you really stay till land, I'm going to give you a lot of gifts. A lot of gifts that can really have a power to change your life. And it will also help you to start your focus journey to the next level, right? Let me share my mind map. An ambitious way. I hope it's visible. Make my camera a little bit big. Is that good, right? Uh-huh. Yeah, now all set to work. An ambitious way to boost your focus easily in just 6 steps every day. A lot of times we are being distracted every single day with social media, with entertainment, with people, with negative thoughts, with our mindset, right? The solution is become hyper focused in your life. The ability to focus is an important skill you should learn, implement, and get the power of focus in your life. You know, whatever your goal, it may be achieve your financial freedom, it may be building a great business, it may be work into your relationships, it may be getting a proper health, become fit. Whatever your goal is, focus is the first step. Do you think your time is very important in your life? But actually your time is not at all an important in this 2020. Where you're investing your focus is very important. Suppose if you wake up and start your day with distractions like WhatsApp or YouTube or entertainment, then you are giving your focus to them where the benefits are zero, even negative, right? If you main focus on distractions, you know, my favorite quote goes like this. If you focus on the shit, shit grows. If you focus on yourself, you grow to the next level, right? Wherever your focus grows, result follows, right? Wherever your focus goes, result follows. In this video, I'm going to go deep down into how you can become that much hyper focused in your life. You know, first, this video has been divided into 4 sections. Why focusing is very difficult? What are the problems you are facing in your life? You know, in most of the times, why you are not solving a problem in your life and not becoming very focused like every other successful entrepreneur in the world? Because you don't aware of the problem, right? I go deep into the type of problems you might have. That might be the reason you're suffering with, you know, distractions and a lot of things. And I go deep into the concepts. And this is what you really want to listen in this video now. A 6-step framework to focus, to boost your focus to the next level. And if you really stay till land and watch this video completely, I'm going to give you a next action steps. Like this mind map and really a gift worth $9.99. Excited? Type ready to focus in the comment box. RTF, ready to focus, right? If you type RTF, let us jump into the concept. You know, why focusing is hard in 2020. And you know, this video is highly power packed, and you know, it's a big disclaimer, is it's very long. It's not that much easy 5 minutes, 2 minutes video. It might be around 20 to 30 minutes, right? Can I have your attention to watch this video till the end? Take your notepad and pen. Pause this video. Take notepad and pen. so that you can grab some notes, inject into your life immediately, implement it so that you will get results. I want your results, right? Excited, okay. Without wasting much time, I go deep into why focusing is very hard in 2020. There are a lot of problems. There are a lot of problems in my research, in my analysis about, you know, I run ads and I found people, what are the problems they're facing regarding productivity? Focus is the main problem. In the focus, there are a lot of distractions in the world, right? In your life, you might have a lot of distractions. There are two types of distractions. It may be internal distractions like worry, exhaustion, tiredness, anxiety, lack of motivation, right? And there are external type of distractions like people, sounds in the environment, and maybe your physical environment, your people, all the things. There are a lot of distractions. If you really want to be hyper-focused, you should handle the distractions in a more productive way, isn't it? Because if you cannot eliminate the distractions completely. Yes, this is a hard truth. As a productivity expert, I really go deep into the distractions already. You can see any other video in my YouTube channel. I go deep into the distractions where you cannot remove the distractions completely. You cannot eliminate it. You can handle it. You can reduce it, right? There are the second problem why focusing is hard, because there are sudden interruptions are coming. Like, you know, those are all false emergencies. You know, maybe your friend will tell you, hey man, come to the movie, or your mom told you to go to groceries, or your family or your kid is asking your priority. There are a lot of sudden interruptions is blocking your focus, right? The third thing is lack of proper mindset. Yes, even your mindset, even you are alone, you know, in your room, no one is there. Only you are opening your laptop or, you know, any notepad or any, you open your notebook to study or any book to read or you want to learn. Still, you cannot focus. You know why? Because the mindset you have is not in the right frame, the right frame of mindset. You should have to be focused, right? I really go deep into all of these problems in the third section. You know, because of your negative thoughts, because of your constantly worrying about your past or constantly worrying about your future, you're constantly thinking about what if I fail, what if I don't get this, what if I don't get results, what if someone scold me, what if someone judge me. All the negative thoughts make you less focused on your life, isn't it? Type true in the comment box if I can directly read your mind now, right? And the fourth thing is not interested in work. Even though you sit someplace, no distractions, no external distractions, no internal distractions, still the work you are going to tackle is very boring, and you're really, really not interested to work, isn't it? Your focus is dependent on lot of variables. You know, the type of work you've been doing is also very important to be focused, right? Sometimes, you know, if you're enjoying using WhatsApp, but you're not enjoying studying, you're enjoying using YouTube, but you're not enjoying building a business, you're enjoying Amazon Prime, but you're not enjoying Udemy. You know why? The type of interest you should have about the work, that can also have an impact on your focus. The fourth thing is the no proper health. You might have struggling with some mental issues or maybe physical issues. Your health is not that much right to focus, right? And the concentration levels are also very low on your life, and you feel very difficult to concentrate on work, right? That is also an issue why you are not focusing. And final thing is, you cannot work much time. You know, a lot of time people ask, Ramesh, how can I improve my focus to at least 6 hours per day? At least one day, the whole day, only on one activity. Or maybe 1 month, one activity. Do you know it's possible? I tell you the reason and solution in the third section, right? And you cannot, because you're constantly switching between tasks. It is called context switching. According to the computer science, a CPU can execute multiple tasks, like that your mind also can execute multiple tasks at a time. Inherently, it's not. It is constantly switching between tasks, which is very costly, which is really very costly. And you are really attracted to easy distractions. Easy distractions in the sense, your internet is always on. You open WhatsApp in one click. you open YouTube in one click. Your notifications are just one unlock away. Am I correct? Right? That all the reasons make you less focused, less successful, maybe a failure, and constantly struggling to come out of that loop. Isn't it? Type in loop in the comment box if you feel you're stuck in that loop. You feel, oh my God, how can I come out of this? How, why all these things has been grabbing me down? If you're thinking like that, just continue the journey. Continue watching this video, right? You understand why focusing is very difficult because a lot of parameters. I'm going to deep into what is focus, and the concept is, the first concept is focus. You know, focus, it's just like a muscle. It's just like a mental muscle. The more you work on building it up, the stronger it gets. I repeat it, you know, focus is a lot like a mental muscle. You know, the more you want focus, the more you should try it. Maybe now you cannot focus much. Maybe you started some work, you feel not interested to do it. You feel it's hard, you feel it's boring. Then you open WhatsApp or you open something else, which is completely entertainment beyond the work. At the end of the day, no results, no achievement, only regret, only demotivation, anxiety, pressing of the deadlines, right? But I'm going to show you a way. You know, focus is nothing but a spotlight. It's a spotlight. Suppose you're in the dark room, you have a torch, you know, hyper-focus spotlight torch. You can only focus on one activity at a time, you know, focus on only one thing at a time with a focus light. Should be laser-like focus, you know. It's just like, I'll tell you with an example how much focus is important to you. In our childhood days, we are more likely, we play this game. You know, we use magnifying glass under sun and we put some paper. We wait for 1 or 2 minutes and we exactly point the magnifying glass on the same place for 1 minute and continuously maybe 2 to 3 minutes based on the intensity of the heat provided by the sun. Paper will burn. When the paper will get smoke, we'll get some smoke, right? We'll get smoke. Once we get smoke, we should be on the same place. Within 30 to 1 minute, you will get fire. And it's one of the happiest moment when we are in childhood. That's the same scenario. That's the same framework. That's the same type of thing you should do to improve your focus. It's just a kind of magnifying glass. Become laser-like focused on one activity. Can you see this? What if I tell you, put magnifying glass 10 seconds somewhere and you're not focusing that much. You are just randomly moving around the paper. Even if you sit for the whole day, you cannot burn the paper. You cannot burn the paper. Can you see this? That's what the focus means. We all know it, you know. We all know it. That's easy, the focus is. It's very easy. It's really very easy. If I can improve my focus, I improve my focus to a next level. I'm building this, you know, productivity empire, and I'm doing my software job at the same time, building 2 successful careers at the same time and enjoying it. How is that possible? I improve my focus to the next level, right? And if I can do it, you can also do it. I believe in you. I really believe in you. You can also improve it. Just follow the 6-step framework what I'm about to give you. Second thing is, multi-focusing is costly. Yes, multi-focusing is costly because if you try to focus on multiple things at the same time, there is some energy, there is some focus it requires to switch the task. This is called context switching, right? Suppose you are watching this video, still you'll get a ping on WhatsApp or maybe Facebook. Then you need to pass this video, then you go to that ping, open it, you know, someone liked your recent photo, you loved it, and you give us some thanks message or something, and you come back. You know, in your mind, what are the things that's happening? You have to remove all the current memory. What is the thing you have in the current memory? Remove it and put it on the hard disk and go to the activity, continue the journey, and come back again. That is called context switching. It's very, very costly. We waste 1/3 of our focus just for context switching. And multitasking and multi-focusing is seems very productive, but actually it's not. Yes, it's really not that much productive. Yes. According to the James Clear, you know, James Clear is one of my favorite author. Is my browser visible? Type visible in the comment box. The myth of multitasking, which is nothing but the multi-focusing. This is the graph. This is the graph. What it shows is the quality of work done on the y-axis, amount of multitasking on the x-axis. It seems, you know, at point A, looks simple, but actually a lot more things done in less time when we have high focus, means, you know, multitasking like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you focus on the one activity and improve the focus, if you focus on only one activity, the work done will be much more higher. You can even do 5x of your work by focusing consistently on one activity. But if you try to do multiple activities like 2 or 3 or 4, if you try to do 3 or 4, then I hope my screen is visible, right? Let me stop share and start sharing it again. Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. I hope now it's visible, right? Okay. If you try to increase the task you have to do at a time, then your quality of work will be reduced, right? B, looks busy and seems productive, but actually it's not, but actually wastes a lot of time. Type awesome if you really feel awesome, you know, because people feel if you try to do multiple things, then you're very productive. Like, you know, listening to the music, using WhatsApp, learning a video, taking notes, hearing to the music on the sound, or maybe anything, all the, you know, 5 to 6 things, but at the same time, but actually you cannot get much. Yes, that is the hard truth. You cannot get much if you try to do many things at the same time. You can see this, right? I'm exactly looking on your face and talking for you, right? Because that is how the focus is important. I'm not listening to anything. I'm not, you know, my phone is somewhere, beyond the room. And my phone is on switch off mode. And I'm exactly focusing on trying to show you how much focus is important to you on the framework, the 6-step framework. Can you see this? If you try to do multiple things by watching this video, you cannot get much. You know, I'm just taking this example as a video. If you try to do multiple, maybe 5 things by watching this video, along with watching this video, then you cannot get much of this video. That is the thing. That is the thing I should be very clear. If you close your room, put your phone somewhere, plug your earphones on, ready to take notes, just watching this video alone can increase your focus to the next level. Can you see this? How much powerful it's important to learn focus? Yes. Let us jump into the mind map again. Third thing is ability to focus. You know, ability to focus is an important skill. Everyone, if you're a student, entrepreneur, or an employer, or an employee, or business owner, focus is very, very important to you. Right? Very, very important. For others like homemakers or anyone, whoever it is, focus plays a key role. In order to improve your relationship, you should focusly spending quality time with your loved ones, right? If you try to, you know, looking at your wife or your spouse and using phone sometime and watching, talking with them, less quality time leads to no relationships. Focus plays a key role anywhere in your life. And it's a biggest unfair advantage, you know, biggest unfair advantage to you. If you learn this framework, that will give you a, you know, big power to you. It's a kind of giving a weapon to you now, right? Yes. And you can train your brain slowly like a baby. Yes. You can train your brain to focus. If you say, Ramesh, I'm not able to focus even 1 minute. I'll tell you a framework, even it may be 30 seconds per day, right? I'm going to slowly increase you. Trying to, you know, train your mind to start focusing on activity. You know, now I just follow the same framework. You know, now I constantly focus on an activity for 4 hours without looking at my phone, without looking at any other thing. I just focus on a single activity. Yes, I'm doing it now. I'm doing it. Are you ready to do it? To increase the focus to next level? Can you close your eyes and imagine if you have that skill, how much you can achieve in your life, how much extra money you can make, how many new relationships you can build with that focus, how you can impact the world, right? That is what I want. I want you to get results by applying the framework, right? Type F in the comment box. Framework, ready to learn, right? Type F in the comment box. We'll jump into a 6-step framework. After I have read 70 plus books on time management and productivity, after I went through a lot of highly successful trainers and coaches, programs and trainings, and I found that focus is also very easy. People need to have some variables to set in a place, you know, it's just a kind of radio frequency. If you put all the variables in the right frequency, you can listen to powerful music. Otherwise, you should have noise, right? I'll show you the 6 variables you should set in your life to become that much of hyper focus in your life, right? Type F in the comment box if you're really ready to learn the 6-step framework. The first step is your passion. I repeat it, you know, your first step is your passion. Your passion is the first thing, then your focus will follow your passion. Your time will follow your focus. You know what it means? If you really found your passion, then your focus will go to that passion. You know, my passion is productivity. My passion is coding. My passion is cooking. My passion is serving people and solving problems. Can you see this? My focus is constantly thinking about all the 5 things. And my time is going where my focus goes. Suppose if you spend 1 hour on YouTube, your focus go to YouTube, your time follows your focus. Can you see this? But your passion is the first thing. Are you really passionate about your work? Are you really passionate about your life? And are you really excited to wake up and really tackle the day, become very productive, increasing the results you want? It may be financial results, it may be business growth, it may be career growth, it may be personal growth, right? The first part of the focus framework is the passion. Do you have that much of passion in your life? If yes, yes, you are on the right place. You can easily improve your focus if you know your passion. If you don't know your passion, your mind is always wandering on multiple things. If your mindset is not right, you're constantly wandering on wrong things like shiny objects. I literally tried 13 plus businesses by wasting 3 years. Wasting 3 years, I was chasing shiny objects. I was chasing wrong things. My mindset was not right at that time. You know why? My focus was not right and I didn't find my passion at that time. Once I found my passion is productivity, then everything fall into the place. You know, my focus is following my passion. My time is following the focus. Can you see this diagram? Passion leads to focus, leads to time. If you really want to manage your time, you understand where your focus is going. If you really want to know where your focus is going, know your passion. It's not about the money. It's not about the results. It's not about the success. It's about the journey. It's about the evolution you have as a person you become. Can you see this? Start with right intention and the commitment you have around your passion. You know, you might think, Ramesh, I have this idea. You might have 6 or 10 ideas. What is your passion? You might say, Ramesh, I have 10 passions. It's not in the ideas that leads to the results, that leads to the transformations. It's about the execution. Are you ready to commit? If not, that's not your passion. That's just a dream. That's just a wish. That's just something is just on air. We cannot make it reality. Can you see this? If you understand your passion and you're working for your passion, your focus is very easy. You can easily focus on your work. Even, you know, before 3 years back, I used to be a person who stammer a lot, who cannot express himself, you know, clearly to the world, cannot face the camera because of the teeth gap I have, because of the inferiority complex I have. You know, my focus was bad at the time. Once I found my passion is productivity, and I started this with the right intention to serve you, to make you more productive, then I committed to do this for the rest of my life, irrespective of the results I get or not. Then my focus is always dedicated to you, to record these videos, to help people, to make more productive. Can you see this? If your passion is right, if your intention is right, and you are committed to do this, your first step is already done. Yes, your first step is already done if you know this. The second step, okay, I'll make this open. The second step is declutter your environment. Declutter your environment. Once you found your passion, okay, if you found your passion, can you comment it below? What is that passion you are very passionate about? Because I really want to see your passions and I can give you the customized insights for you personally. I reply back to your comment. If you're watching this on YouTube or Facebook, the second step is to declutter your environment. There are four environments you have. Four environments. One, physical, mental, digital, emotional. No, I repeat it again. Physical, mental, digital, emotional. Don't think environment is not the only physical environment or the room or the workplace. You have four types of environments you have. Right? From now on, when I say environment, all the four things will be applicable. All the four things will be applicable if I say environment. First, the physical environment, your room, your house, your office, your car, you know, your people, all the things, your environment. If you say all the messy things around on your room, you cannot focus much because your physical environment has an impact on your work, on your focus. If you sit in a room where the room is messy, you cannot work focusedly. You cannot concentrate on a work much time if your room is messy, or if your environment, if your place is messy, the physical place I'm talking about, right? Make sure you organize everything, put everything in place, make it very clean, dirt free, very, you know, the smell should be good and the real right environment. Can you see this? Your physical environment should be decluttered. Then your mental environment, like your thoughts in the sense, the intentions. Yes, I'll write it down so that it will be more effective, right? Thoughts, your belief system. Are you believing in the right thing? Are you believing in positive things? Are you believing in becoming a better person and improving your focus? Your thoughts, your beliefs, your mental habits. What are your habits? Your habits determine a lot. Right, your routines, your micro routines, your habits, your routines. Can you see this? Type awesome if you really feel it's awesome, because your mental environment should be decluttered clearly. All the thoughts, all the negative habits, all the messy things going on around, worrying about the past, thinking about the future. Can you see this? Just declutter it one by one. Digital environment in the sense, smartphone, desktop, whatever the device you're using, it may be tablet, it may be, you know, Mac or anything. Just declutter it, make it very organized. You know, whenever you are working with laptop, you should feel a sense of focus before you start the work. If I open my desktop, it will be very cleaned. It will be very clean with 5 to 6 icons. If your desktop is with maybe 30 icons or 50 icons, completely disorganized, you cannot work much. You cannot work because your mind cannot focus on the messy thing. Your mind is a baby. If you try to confuse it with many times, with many things, with multiple activities, it can never give results. You should give only one thing at a time. It should be very organized. Can you see this? And your emotional environment is nothing but your feelings. Anger, sad, afraid, you know, worry, your feelings. If your feelings, suppose if you have a grudge on someone, or you're jealous on someone, or maybe you feel bad about something, you're constantly thinking about something had happened on the past, you know, you cannot focus much. You cannot focus much. It's very hard to declutter it one by one. You know, everything happens. Sad thing happens. We lost someone. And you know, we lost our business, we fail a lot of times, and we got less marks in the exam, and we fail in the exam as well, right? Just remove all the unnecessary burden you are having. Remove them one by one. Remove them, because it won't serve you to grow. It won't serve you to help. It really won't make you a better person. Just declutter your environment. Environment in the sense, physical, mental, digital, emotional, right? I hope you are taking notes, because I put my life into this video. I did 3 days of research to get this done. And whatever I'm talking is just my walking. You know, I really walk my talk every single minute. And the third step in the framework, Ivy Lee method, you know, Ivy Lee is a powerful scientist. Maybe in 1960s, he created one framework, which is this. Before sleep, write top 3 to 6 activities you should do per day. Top 3 to 6 activities. Once you write, maybe 3 or 4, or maybe 3 to 6, don't write too much, only 3 to 6. Once you write 3 to 6 activities, then prioritize them 1 to 6, rank them 1, 2, oh, this should be done first, this should be second, this should be third, this should be fourth, like that. Organize them, you know, organize them by importance. Then after you wake up, open that sheet, find an activity which is ranking 1. Then, you know, just inject that into your mind, start working on it, one task at a time. Just start working on it. Just once it is done, then go to a second activity. Once it is done, go to the third activity. Maybe all the 6 cannot be done, right? At the end of the day, find what's not done, you know, use it, you know, just push it to the next day. Can you see this? It's a very, very simple framework to improve your focus, Ivy Lee method, right? And you, in this method, I'm adding this, my own flavor to this Ivy Lee method. You can use artificial deadlines in the sense, there is no external pressure if you don't have deadline. Your mind is always wandering. Suppose the exam is after 2 months, you cannot focus. You cannot read a chapter now. Suppose the deadline to submit a project is after 6 weeks. You cannot focus now. Your mind won't allow you to focus. In order to avoid that problem, use artificial deadlines. Impose yourself some problem, you know, some kind of artificial deadline. You know, just cheating your mind and hacking your mind to finish an activity. And in most of the cases, work will be expanded based on the time given. Right? Suppose if I give 3 days to research for this video, 3 days is done. If I give 10 days, yes, 10 days will be taken. If I give 1 month, 1 month will be taken for this video, for the same video. Because our mind is expanded, it's just a fluid. Expanded or, you know, constrained based on the time given. So use soft pressure on yourself, like before afternoon I should do these 2 activities. You can use reward system, or you can use punishments, you can use milestones, you know, there are a lot of things to make a work, you know, to make a work done. If you're really excited, I'm doing a 5-day boot camp which is called Super Productive Boot Camp. You and me gonna meet live every day to make you more productive. If you're really excited, the link is in the description. Just click the link below. It is just 99. You will get 10,000 of value, just 10,000 of the value. And you really go deep into it and make you more productive. You know, it is starting from this Monday on the next Monday. Create an artificial deadlines to implement this Ivy Lee method so that you only focus on the one thing at a time, only the top activity. And the fourth thing is, measure the progress, track the progress. You know why you're addicted to Facebook and why you're addicted to YouTube? You know why? Because of the numbers your mind is playing with. Yes. The honest truth a lot of normal people miss is they don't track anything, right? How many variables are you tracking in your life? Can you close your eyes and tell? Can you type in the comment box what is the thing you are tracking in your life? I'm tracking 17 plus parameters in my life. Can I say, for example, I'm tracking how many hours I'm sleeping, how many liters of water I'm drinking, and how much time I'm exercising, how many reps, sets. It's my personal life. In my professional life, in my business, I'm tracking how many leads, how many sales, how many ads running, the metrics, numbers, everything is measured, you know, completely. Because why I'm talking more about the members, numbers and metrics, because we'll easily find the gap, easily find the difference, and there is a benchmark. You know, my favorite author, Brendan told that if you measure something, you can have a benchmark. If you say, Ramesh, I got six, six is the absolute number, there is no metric for that, just six, then you have a benchmark called six. Then for the next time, for the next cycle, if you get seven, you feel that you're progressing forwards. If you get five, you know that there is something lagging behind. There is something you should work on again. Can you see this? Six is a benchmark here. In the same way, if you track something, if you're a student, you can track number of hours you're studying per day. If you're an entrepreneur, you can track your leads, sales, ads, posts. You can track everything, can I say? If you're a business magnet, you can track everything. You can track a lot of parameters. If you're an employee, you can track how many hours you are very productive, how many hours you are in the meeting, how much work you have done per day, how many issues you have solved per day. You know, there are a lot of things. If you really go deeply, you can track everything in the world. Yes, you can track everything in the world. Why we are addicted to distraction? Because they're all numbers. They're very progressive. Like, you know, likes is a number. Number of comments is a number. Number of chats, you know, new messages got. We have, you know, some six or seven. That's a number. In statuses also, we have a new dot, right? That's a number. We'll get number of statuses will be updated. You can see this. Even YouTube likes, comments, number of views, subscribers. Everything is a number which is very addictive. I'm using the same framework to create some quantifiable measure to become more focused. Suppose if you want to create a reading habit, try to measure number of pages you are reading per day. Start with one page per day. One is a benchmark now. Increase it to 1.5. Increase it to 2 per day. Slowly increase it to 3, 4, 5. At one day, you can read a book a day. It's possible if you measure it. Otherwise, you're in the same loop. You're struggling with the same results. You're struggling with the same activity. And you're blaming anyone in the world. And you say that, you know, nothing works. But actually, you're not tracking anything. Just track something. Just note it down anywhere. You can use diary, journal, notepad. You can use calendar. You can use Trello. Keep a lot of things. Can you see this? Measure the progress. Like, you know, whenever you measure something, your dopamine hits. The happiness hormone will hit. And will give you a feedback mechanism to your mind. So that your mind is really enjoying to do it again. Suppose if you, a new photo of you posted on Facebook. You posted yesterday and you slept. You wake up tomorrow and see 17 likes. Imagine that is a number. 17 likes. You mind say, oh my God, we got some progress from 0 to 17 likes. That's a progress. That is called dopamine hits. You know, for every minute you're opening the post and refreshing the screen to see the progress, to see the numbers growing. Because your mind is addicted to it. Why not? We are using the same hack to a positive thing, like reading a book. Can you see this? That is how you can improve your focus. Even whatever the boring task you are doing, measure something, quantify something, quantify the results. Then the real magic happens. Yes, that's where the real magic happens. And we all people, you know, every human being in the world will addict to the progress, not to success. We are addicted to this progress. Progress is nothing but the journey we enjoyed. Suppose if I say I have 100 subscribers, you know, my brother is asking, you know, bro, how many subscribers you got so far? Every week he is asking the same question. You know, that is the number. His mind is very happy to ask it. How many people you joined? You know, how many people entered into the bootcamp? How many problems you solved? You can see this, right? The number is a very, very important thing. I cannot press more on. It's very, very important. You can track anything. If you feel something you cannot track, just comment below. Suppose you have the question, Ramesh, how can I track this? How can I make it into a more number? Then I can give you the insights. I can give you my personal insights to you. Can you see this? And the fifth thing in this frame framework to become, to boost your focus to the next level, strategic breaks. You cannot focus more than 4 or 5 hours. It's very, very hard because we are all biological beings. We are not robots. We are not aliens. We are human beings. There are some limits, right? For, as a human being, we have a limits. Like, we cannot focus much. We cannot focus much. I tell you the numbers. We only focus, most of the cases, 90 minutes max. 90 minutes. So make sure you work in 90-minute cycle. 90 minutes walk or 20 minutes break. Or even you can use Pomodoro technique, like 25 minutes work and 5 minutes break. It's completely up to you. But make sure you are taking breaks. Breaks give you a way to recharge your mind so that your mind is ready for the next focus goal, next focused activity. Suppose after watching this video, I take half an hour break, then I come back to publish it on YouTube, publish it on all my social channels. Can you see this? Take some break, and break should be completely different than what you're doing on the work. Suppose if your work is mostly work with laptop, work with screens, then completely avoid it in the break time so that your mind has time to connect the dots. And Steve Jobs told, that is my favorite quote, dots will connect always backward, in the sense, once you finish the focused activity, you take break. In the break, that the dots will be connected. In the focused activity, you'll get new insights. How awesome is that? Type awesome in the comment box, because no one will really give you this much of powerful stuff anywhere in the world, right? Maybe you'll get, but I really go deep into this. I'm very passionate about this subject, and I'm here to serve you, to make you more productive, right? Make sure you are, you know, I will add that point. Break should be completely different. Suppose you're working with people, you know, after spending 90 minutes with the laptop, don't open the phone again. That is not a break. That is called context switching. Just remove the digital devices while breaking, like spending time with nature, have a small walk, have a coffee, or even you can focus on your meditation, you know, mindfulness meditation. Can you see this? That's how you can improve your focus, boost your focus to the next level. I hope you are really enjoying this video, right? And finally, health tweaks. Health, you know, if I close this video without this concept, without this sixth step, then I was the fool in the world, right? Without proper health, you cannot be very focused. In order to become hyper-focused, in order to monomanically focus in your life, you should follow some guidelines for your health. That is called health tweaks. Get good enough sleep. Have some sleep, you know. Don't try to cheat yourself by, you know, reducing your sleep hours to less. Give 8 hours, right? If you try to reduce hours to 7 or 6, you have to pay the cost. It is very costly in the form of lack of focus, no concentration, health issues, a lot of stuff, right? Even I used to be a person who sleep very less to work more, but that is completely a counterproductive activity in the world. Sleep 8 hours, having proper nutrition without bad habits like smoking, drinking, drugs, remove all of them, because all these inputs you are giving to your mind and body will have an effect on focus. Yes. And do some meditative activities like, you know, mindfulness meditation, or maybe breathe meditation, or maybe, you know, some yoga or anything. Just do some mindfulness activities so that your focus will be trained like a muscle and it will build over time. And finally, do some physical activity. That is called exercise routine. Do some physical activity. It may be 5 to 10 minutes if you're very busy. It may be a small walking to a, you know, high intensive workouts in the gym. It is up to you. You can choose anything you want. There is no constraint here. You can choose any physical activity you want, but make sure you move your body at least 20 minutes per day, so that all the hormones will be balanced in such a way that your focus will be improved. I hope you enjoy this framework. I repeat it again. you should have the focus, you should have the passion, and your passion leads to focus, leads to time. Declutter your environment completely, all the physical, digital, emotional, and mental. And use the Ivy method to find the top three things or three to six things per day. Focus on one thing at a time after prioritizing them. Use the artificial deadlines to create some pressure on you, some soft pressure on you, not too much pressure. And measure the progress. Try to measure something so that it will be addicted. You'll be addicted to the results, addicted to the progress. Use strategic breaks so that you are ready for the next focus sessions and you enjoy the journey. And finally, do the health tweaks. Health tweaks. Having these health tweaks to become hyper-focused in your life. That's the biggest promise from my side. You can follow this exact framework to improve your focus. And if you start implementing it now, after 7 days, you will be the completely different person. That is my biggest promise. You can take a screenshot of it. And if you really want to know more, are you excited for the next action steps? The first action step is, do you want this mind map? This is a powerful mind map, which really, you can revise it anytime you want. Just go to this link, bit.ly/ry_messenger. It will open my chatbot. You can type focus. If you type focus, this document, this PDF, this image, this mind map will come to you as a guide, as a PDF, right? You can download it. And second thing, how many of you are ready to implement and ready go deep into this? How many of you are ready? Are you ready to make this into action? Put it into your guard mode, make you into an autopilot mode, improve your focus to the next level and become very productive in your life. Then I'm inviting to your brand new online 5-day journey with me called Super Productive Bootcamp. In the bootcamp, I go deep into about focus, procrastination, distractions, micro habits, and final FDC framework to boost your productivity. You know, just go to this link, bit.ly/SPBC, Super Productive Bootcamp 90% off. I'm giving a 90% off. It is just 99 rupees. Because I charge very less, it doesn't mean the value is low. I really want to serve you first before I charge more. Right, just click the, you know, this link is also in the description. You can jump into the boot camp immediately, where this 90% off will be removed very soon. You might have to pay 999, or if you can jump now, the boot camp will start from this Monday on, so that you can start your super productive journey with me. And and if you're really excited, jump into the boot camp, where you can become very productive. And if you're watching this on Facebook, hit the love symbol or like symbol and comment below what are your top three takeaways. And if you're watching this on YouTube, just hit the subscribe button and like it. First like it, then subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that a lot more powerful tutorials like this will about to come. And I'm planning to do this every week for the rest of my life. And thank you for watching this video. I hope I am going to see you in the Super Productive Bootcamp and you really enjoyed this video. Share this video to one person who really needs to listen this. Thanks for your time and attention. This is Ramesh Yadav, son to an awesome couple, fitness freak, swimmer, writer, online gamer, turned a productivity expert, and the creator of the Personal Productivity Empire. Bye.